When it comes to buying the right products, there's a lot to look out for. That's why today, we've picked and reviewed the 5 best models for you. And we've ranked them by many different factors, such as price, quality, durability, performance, and more. You can see their prices and find out more information by using the links in the description down below. Let's not waste any more time and get started with the video. Next up, we have a model which gives you the best value for your money.
Number 5, Lenovo Flex 5. With the introduction of the premium Yoga series, Lenovo has started its 2-in-1 flagship laptop series. However, sometime later they launched the Flex series, which are also 2-in-1 laptops with affordable prices to reach a bigger base of customers. The Lenovo Flex 5 is an affordable and stylish device, also packing a great amount of power, all while being a 2-in-1. Flex 5 has a simple two-tone design, which is pretty slick. The lid is black plastic, the deck is gunmetal grey aluminium. Overall, the case is pretty beautiful without losing function and sturdiness. The laptop is 4.1 pounds heavy and 0.8 inches thick. It's on the larger side of the spectrum, but it is carryable nonetheless. Because of its flexibility, it can be used as a laptop, tablet, display, and in the tent mode. The screen on the Flex 5 is a 14-inch 1920 by 1080 touch display, which is kind of dark and doesn't offer a lot of colors. The panel offers just 74% of the sRGB color gamut, which is below par. The brightness is 242 nits at maximum, pretty mediocre. The viewing experience is decent at best, but at least the colors were accurate. The keyboard is nice, it maybe doesn't have a really long key travel, but it is pretty good. The touchpad is also quite nice, quite responsive and accurate at all times. In terms of performance, the Lenovo Flex 5 comes with 2.7 GHz Intel Core i7-7500U CPU, 16 GB of RAM, a 1 TB 5400 HDD, 128 GB SSD and an NVIDIA 940 MX GPU with 2 GB of VRAM. This can handle everything thrown at it during everyday usage with ease. In performance benchmark tests, it has fared well. The graphics card, while not being proper for gaming, will give you a better and faster performance in Photoshop. In the 3D Mark I Storm Unlimited benchmark test, it achieved a score of 1005373, surpassing the average. The battery is average too, giving you about 8 hours of continuous web surfing. Despite having a lackluster display and average features, it's a seriously good and affordable option if you're considering getting into the 2-in-1 craze.
If portability is important to you, then I would recommend this next model.
Number 4, Microsoft Surface Go 2. If you're looking for a portable tablet-laptop combo that you can take with you wherever you go, then the Surface Go 2 will be a perfect choice for you. If you're unfamiliar, the Surface Go 2 is a Windows tablet that's about the same size as a regular iPad or the 11-inch iPad Pro, but because it's a Surface, it has a few accoutrements that iPads lack. It has a kickstand that works at any angle, a micro SD card slot for expandable storage, a Surface connector to go along with its USB-C port, and a headphone jack. Even though this can be considered a tablet, unlike iPads and Android tablets, the Surface Go 2 ships with a real desktop operating system, Windows 10. It's nice because in theory all the power of Windows and the ability to run any desktop application are baked in. While the Surface Go 2's 10.5 inch screen is only a half inch larger than its predecessor screen, measured diagonally, it includes more pixels for a slightly higher native resolution, 1920 by 1280, which translates into a density of 220 pixels per inch PPI. This is significantly less than the iPad's 264 PPI. The Surface Go 2 will be the perfect laptop-tablet hybrid for some people, just like how the iPad is the perfect laptop-tablet hybrid for others. The Surface Go 2, on the other hand, is much more useful as a laptop, capable of everyday tasks. It's also a decent tablet for watching Netflix or reading books. If you want a tiny, lightweight laptop that can double as a tablet, this one is one of the best options available right now. With this model, Microsoft appears to have succeeded in its quest to make the Surface Go 2 an essential tool for a new era of working and learning from home, and I think that this laptop-tablet combo would be a perfect option for students and those who work from home.
If you're looking for a mid-range model, then this next pick is a great option.
Number 3, Acer Aspire 5. This laptop is a great one that delivers more performance for your money than you expect. It has many great features and it's very inexpensive. Even though it's an inexpensive laptop, it has great overall performance and the design looks quite premium. It has a nice 15.6-inch Full HD display, which looks amazing, nice design, and the performance is amazing. As I said, the design is pretty cool. It may not be like other high-priced laptops, but it still doesn't disappoint. It has nothing too flashy, and it's mainly made of plastic with a textured surface on the lid. In my opinion, it still looks pretty good. It weighs around 5 pounds. The bezels are a bit thick, but at least they give more space on the keyboard. It comes with two USB 2.0 ports, one USB-C port, a USB 3.0, an SD memory card port, and an Ethernet port. The keyboard and the touchpad are pretty large on this one. The keyboard has a nice size and makes typing more comfortable for long periods. Also, the touchpad is very large too because of the multi-finger gestures. The Full HD 1920x1080 display looks amazing, and the IPS screen is pretty decent. Also, it has the Color Intelligence technology, which can help a lot with the adjustment of the gamma and saturation for better and sharper colors. It has an AMD Ryzen 3 3200U dual-core processor up to 3.5 GHz, with 4GB DDR4 memory and 128GB SSD. It also has AMD Radeon Vega 3 graphics coprocessor. It's not made for gaming, but you can play some games from time to time. The overall performance of this laptop is great, taking into account that this is not a top-notch and high-priced laptop, it still does an amazing job. It can tackle almost any job, no matter how complex. The audio system is good enough on this one. It has the Acer True Harmony, which can give you deeper bass and more volume. It's packed with 48 watt-hours of battery, which is pretty impressive. It can last up to 7.5 hours without a problem. This laptop has a great design and a good build quality. The performance is good enough and the battery life is superb. If you want a budget laptop that offers great overall performance, you should take a look at this one and see if it can satisfy your needs.
This next model is the best option for gaming. And I think that this would be a great fit for any type of gamer.
Number 2, Acer Nitro 5. Next up, we have the Acer Nitro 5, which is one of the best budget gaming laptops you can find out there. It might be a bit old by today's standards, but it still can run most of the modern AAA games in full HD settings with great frame rates. It might not have the most interesting design or something of a similar nature, but it is an all-star without a doubt, so let's check it out. In the design and aesthetics perspective, like I said, the Acer Nitro 5 is not the most streamlined or sleekest device. It's also pretty substantial at 5.4 pounds in total and measures about an inch at its thickest. It has a brushed aluminium design that gives it a bit classier look compared to the rest of the body. The crimson-red hinges look pretty complementary on the overall design, complete with the backlighting on the keyboard in the same colour. The design is decent at best, but it's good since this one is dedicated as a budget gaming device. Also, the build quality is perfect overall. On the front side, the Acer Nitro 5 is packed with a 15.6-inch 1920x1080 display that's pretty sharp overall and emits good colours. I found it a little dim compared to the average, but you probably won't use it under direct sunlight. The in-plane switching panel has some good wide viewing angles, and without forgetting, I should state that the keyboard is rather snappy with a good key travel and a clicky feeling. The trackpad is mediocre at best, but has a nice size. Now we're coming to the main selling point of this laptop, the performance. It's one of the most impressive I've ever seen at this price. It's great for gaming, productivity, and even some graphical work as well. It can run all contemporary AAA games with at least 30 frames per second at full HD with impressive settings. It does that based on the Intel Core i5-7300HQ CPU, 8GB of RAM and 256GB of high-speed SSD. In addition to that, it's armed with an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1050i with 4GB of dedicated VRAM that's rather powerful for its price.
Finally, the next model is the best overall. From us, it gets a perfect score in all categories.
Number 1, Asus VivoBook 15. Asus has always managed to deliver one of the best laptops in the market, always delivering innovation and value for the price. One of my favorite laptops from its lineup is the Asus VivoBook S15. This one is a budget-focused device that delivers more than you would expect from it. It comes with some great overall specs, slim build, excellent playful design, and a nice display to wrap it up. Let's take a look at this budget laptop. This laptop is designed and manufactured for users that seek a nice and powerful enough laptop without spending the big bucks. And amazingly, it does that perfectly. I've tried a lot of budget laptops from the company's lineup, but the VivoBook S15 has definitely achieved the unachievable, making it one of the best affordable laptops in the market. Today, we're going to take a look at the value-based model, which comes equipped with an 8th generation Intel Core i5-8265U CPU, with a boost clock speed of 3.4 GHz, 8 GB RAM and 256 GB of SSD. It's packed with a 15.6-inch Full HD 1080p resolution wide-view panel with nano-edge bezels. One of the most notable features of this laptop is its ErgoLift hinge that tilts the keyboard to 3.5 degrees for ergonomics, and the ScreenPad 2.0 that adds to the convenience. Upon unboxing, I saw that I had a pretty aesthetically pleasing laptop in my hands. The Asus Vivo S15 comes in different colors you can choose from, including the Firmament Green with Aquamarine Blue, but I chose the Silver Blue with yellow trim for today's review, which looks fantastic. It's extremely portable and light despite its 15-inch panel, as it measures 0.7 inches at its thickest and weighs just 3.5 pounds. The display of this panel is pretty much adequate for the price point, delivering just enough sharpness, brightness, and colors to justify its price, but not its strongest suit. The performance specs of this device made it a powerful multitasking machine, and I was pleased with its performance, but its battery life was a bit lacking as it shut down around the 8-hour mark, which is still pretty good. For those that are shopping in the budget range, this is one of the best options. Buying guide. Size. Depending on what you plan to be doing with your next laptop, you'll want to make sure you pick the size that's the right fit for you. Size isn't like the RAM or ROM of a laptop. You can't upgrade it later. You're locked into whatever you select up front, so choose wisely. Keyboard quality. For long typing sessions, you'll want to get a laptop that has a comfortable keyboard. You don't want a keyboard that packs in every key under the sun, think keyboards that have squished in number pads, because that can translate to a poor overall user experience when hunting for specifics like the arrow or delete keys. RAM. In the old days, you rarely needed more than 4 GB of RAM or more to get the best out of your system. These days, you'll probably want to think about 8 GB as a minimum. If you're a power user, 16 GB is the way to go. Meanwhile, gamers should look at dialing things upwards all the way to 32 GB if they want the best experience. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.